Here's the final skater in the competition, Jeri Campbell of Garden City, Michigan, in fourth place, coming to her final performance.
Beautiful layback spin, the speed, the arms, very similar arm positions as Debi Thomas did earlier in her layback spin.
She's last year's national junior champion.
I think she has potential. The elements of technique and a sense of music are there. In that jump, beautiful position on the landing.
Quick turning, quick revolution.
So now coming up is her first triple jump. She's the only girl in this competition that's attempting a triple Lutz jump. Very difficult. Taking off from this back edge. Oh, that's the kind of things that can go wrong in a triple Lutz.
So she caught an edge before she even got to the toe pick part of the jump.
You could sort of hear it over here, crunching down. Now a triple toe. These are such difficult jumps for the women to be doing, or anybody to be doing. I've seen her in practice all week. She was doing this in the practice, this traveling camel. Look at this speed. It's very difficult to keep the leg in that high position as she's traveling over the ice, and then the final spin.
Beautiful leg.
This is what got the audience going in the warm-up. Look at this position. That is beautiful. Very nice job.
So it's just unfortunate that she, like the other girl, just relinquished all of those triple jumps that she had planned. Very hard. But pressure is really enormous, isn't it?
Jeri Michelle Campbell of Garden City, Michigan, the final skater, will be back with the results and have a word with the champion and other members of the team going to Calgary. We'll be back. The 1988 U.S. Figure Skating Champion. It's official now. Debi Thomas has regained the United States National Championship that she lost last year to Jill Trenary. Trenary has moved up from third to second. with her final performance, and Careyn Kadavy finishes third. It's also official that they will be the three members of the United States women's team for the Olympics in Calgary next month. Here is the way some of the others finished in this competition. A beautiful ladies' competition here, a big crowd, capacity crowd of about 16,000. And now David Santee is surrounded by three very beautiful and talented women and one pretty good-looking guy who had a great performance himself in these championships. David?
It's my fortune to have the entire women's Olympic team for 1988 with me, as well as Brian Boitano. Your thoughts going into Calgary?
I'm really looking for a good competition. I think it's the strongest team, men and women, that we've ever had. And I think it should be a good showdown. I hope that we'll all be at our peak.
I'm just so happy to have this over with, and I'm excited. I can't believe I'm going to the Olympics. It's great. I'm excited.
This is your first chance to go to the Olympics too, Debi.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. This is my last year in here, and I really want to make it one of my best performances. I'm glad I could skate well here.
Careyn?
Yes, very exciting. I'm so excited to be going to the Olympics, and it's a dream come true. Thank you.
Many people have said that the hardest thing about an Olympic year is going through the national championships. Would you agree with that?
Well, sometimes it is, because it's, you know, the competition beforehand, and, you know, we're all trying to do our best, and it's just, I feel it's just a warm-up, and it just feels great. I think maybe that's why I just put the pressure out a little bit more before the Olympics.
Debi?
I agree. I'm glad this is over with. This is one stepping stone on the way to the Olympics, and the Olympics is the big one, so I'm glad I could perform well here, because there was a lot of pressure on me.
Jill, you came out of nowhere last year to become the national champion. This year, was it a tough thing to deal with all that?
This Nationals was much harder than last year, just because I just felt a little bit more pressure on myself. I'm very pleased. I felt that I was tough through the whole competition, and you know, I have to be satisfied with second, and I'm excited to go and perform my best at the Olympics.
Brian, you competed in the 1984 Olympics. This time around, anything different?
Well, I think so. It's harder because I'm one of the co-favorites, so in that respect, it will be a lot more pressure and a lot more people looking at you to hopefully win a medal.
We have three great chances for a medal in Calgary. Are you guys going to gang up on Katarina Witt?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yes, definitely.
Back to Jim.
I didn't get to play my
Okay, time. David, thanks very much. You know, we tend to focus so much, Peggy and Dick, on medals, gold medals, silver medals, bronze medals. We sometimes tend to forget what an honor it is to once in your life be in the Olympic Games. People don't understand that, do they?
No, and it reaches your heart. It's the moment, and I think it's the peak of any amateur career. You know, when you, the pressure on these people to be such extraordinary gymnastic circus athletes, and the pressure on them, and at the same time to be beautiful and lovely and gracious and romantic looking, the pressure is extraordinary. I just love it. My heart goes out to them. I think they're beautiful.
Well, this was a great competition. Peggy, what do you see in Calgary after this? Katarina Witt is still going to be very difficult to beat.
Now, there was a lot of talent out there tonight, and I think they are going to make up a fabulous team for the United States, and I think they're going to give Katarina Witt a lot of uncomfortable times down there. So it's going to be interesting.
Well, let's have a look at what's happening out in the arena there. They're introducing the members of the Olympic team, ladies division, and they do use the word lady in figure skating. It's the ladies championship, not the women, right?
Don't worry about it when you get letters saying call them women instead of ladies. They're both, aren't they?
They certainly are, all the way.
Look at the bounces she goes.
Second place, silver medal here. You'll seldom see anybody this happy when they've just lost their championship.
That's true. She is just a darling competitor, very determined girl. She knows exactly what she's got to do.
Here's the champ.
Debi Thomas.
Got a lot of moxie, doesn't she? She really is a tough lady, but with charm and a sense of humor. And
what a life she can have ahead of her. The achievement of going to the Olympics, possibly winning, and then to be a doctor, graduate of Stanford University.
You know, and right now, one moment it's a college sorority gal with a little bit of a chip on her shoulder and cheeky, and yet at the same time one of the great traditional skaters of all time.
Look at that. Just terrific.
She's got a sense of humor, doesn't she? A wit.
Standing there with him down on the ice is Jeri Campbell, who finished fourth. She'll be the alternate on the team.
Well, this is
got to give her a lot of confidence going to Calgary, having this championship behind her. I know she could have skated better, and I'm sure that she's feeling the same way. So I think this is a good confidence builder going to the Olympics.
Well, maybe Katarina Witt will find out whether or not Debi Thomas warrants that adjective she chose for herself, invincible. It may fit. And there's a look at Jeri Campbell. She'll be the alternate. And this was a big night for her, competing in the final group, finishing fourth in the United States National Championships. Remember, Calgary is not far away. 35 days, that's all, until the opening ceremonies on February 13th. ABC Sports will be bringing all of it to you, start to finish, 16 days. I think just over 100 hours are scheduled. And stock in all your supplies.